Did you know? Hideo Kojima originally envisioned Metal Gear Solid as a recreation of Metal Gear 2, Solid Snake. Metal Gear 2 was originally released for the MSX2 home computer system. While the system was popular in Asia, they were rare elsewhere. Because of this, Metal Gear 2 wasn't released outside of Japan until 2006, where it was repackaged with Metal Gear Solid 3 Subsistence. Many of the gameplay components in Metal Gear Solid were introduced 8 years earlier in Metal Gear 2. Players were given the task of rescuing a female contact, Holly White, after her cover was blown. A similar situation played out in Metal Gear Solid with Meryl Silverberg. The female contact in both games operates on radio frequency 140.15 and becomes romantically involved with Snake. Gray Fox was not the first ally-turned-enemy ninja in the Metal Gear series either. After defeating the Metal Gear 2 boss, Black Ninja, he is revealed to be Kyle Schneider, who helped Snake in the original Metal Gear. Metal Gear 2 also had a chase scene up a spiral staircase, an ambush by four hidden attackers in an elevator, and a battle with a Hind D chopper using stinger missiles. It even had a radio frequency on the game box needed to progress the game, just like in Metal Gear Solid. While Metal Gear 2 Solid Snake provided a baseline for Metal Gear Solid, technological changes made it possible to present Snake in 3D for the first time. This meant he had to be a more physically fleshed out character. Kojima assigned concept artist Yoji Shinkawa to design the character. Kojima said, "I asked Shinkawa to create an older, hard-boiled dandy character, but he said it's better to have a younger character. So Solid Snake became about 20 to 40. I asked him to make the character nimble and muscular, but with the body like a Van Damme. Regarding the face of the character, I wanted it to be something like Christopher Walken. The result came out to be the one you will see in the game. It's not like a Schwarzenegger at all. He has to perform espionage, so I wanted the character to be like a cat, but still have a strong presence." Another major influence on Snake's character came from the 1981 John Carpenter film Escape from New York. Kojima has openly admitted that he drew inspiration from the film's protagonist, Snake Plissken, when creating Solid Snake. During an October 2015 interview with The Hollywood Reporter, Carpenter mentions that Canal Plus, one of the rights holders of the film, wanted to go after Metal Gear Solid for copyright infringement. Carpenter, as one of the other rights holders, explained, "I told them not to do that. I know the director of these games and he's a nice guy, or at least he's nice to me." Before going into video games, Kojima admitted that he wanted to be a director. In a special promotion carried out by Japan's largest video retail chain, Tsutaya, they created a list of 15 magnificent movies that influenced Metal Gear Solid. Among these films are The Guns of Navarone, The Great Escape, Goldfinger, Die Hard, Full Metal Jacket, and Dawn of the Dead. Kojima has said that Planet of the Apes gave him the courage to create a video game with a strong anti-nuclear stance, which became a running theme in all of his games. Predator supplied the idea for the stealth camouflage suit worn by the cyborg ninja Gray Fox. The true names of Solid Snake and Otacon, David and Hal, originated from Kojima's favorite film of all time, Stanley Kubrick's 2001 A Space Odyssey. If the player gets the Otacon ending, the two have an exchange that acknowledges the reference. Some fans have speculated that Snake was named for his voice actor David Hayter. This is incorrect and purely coincidental. Unlike most games at the time, Metal Gear Solid used professional actors to portray characters. Unfortunately, because of the blurred lines between games and the Screen Actors Guild rules, many of the voice actors used aliases. The only exception was David Hayter. However, under the credits for the European version of the game, the voice of Snake was listed as Sean Barker. This was the alias Hayter created based on the character he played in the 1994 live-action movie Guyver, Dark Hero. All of the real names were finally published in the game's 2004 GameCube remake, Metal Gear Solid: The Twin Snakes. The game also includes a re-recorded script using almost the exact same cast. Hayter actually gave up half his salary so Konami could afford to bring back the original cast for The Twin Snakes. Metal Gear Solid was revolutionary because of its use of 3D in-game cutscenes. Kojima has said that he aimed to create a game that was not only graphically superior, but more importantly, create a realistic experience. In order to do this, he created all of the cutscenes with polygons rendered in real time on the PlayStation's hardware. The only pre-rendered CG used for the game was created for promotional purposes. The word Solid in the title had three meanings. The first meaning was a reference to Snake's name being Solid Snake. Another meaning was to emphasize the switch from 2D to a more solid world of 3D. The third meaning was a jab at the video game company Square. Kojima told the publication Gamers Today, "A square is a two-dimension thing, and I guess the president of Konami wanted this game to surpass Square. They wanted to make it a cube, you know, like solid 3D, so it's got that meaning too." In order to create his solid world, Kojima used Lego bricks to plan out each level. The team would then position cameras over each structure in order to give them a real-time perspective of the layout and proportions, allowing Kojima to direct the entire scene. This process took as long as it sounds and was very taxing on Kojima's family life. During a presentation at the University of Southern California, Kojima explained that his son would see his work and report back to his mother that his dad plays with Legos all day. The game also has quite a few secrets and Easter eggs. While going through the caves, if the player faces Meryl and slaps her, she whistles and the wolves will attack Snake. However, if the player can immediately hide under a cardboard box after the slap, a wolf will venture over, lift its leg, and urinate on the box. Using the pee-soaked box will allow the player to move through this area without being hassled by those wolves. Speaking of Meryl, Metal Gear Solid was not the first time she's shown up in a Kojima game. Her character originated in Kojima's 1994 adventure game, Police Knots. References to Police Knots can be found throughout Metal Gear Solid. In Otacon's office, there's a poster of the Police Knots box art, and during Meryl's ending, she laughs and calls Snake Dave. Even though Snake's name is a reference to Dave from 2001 A Space Odyssey, this interaction possibly references Meryl's interactions with her Police Knot partner, Dave Forrest. Kojima envisioned Meryl's character in the original Metal Gear Solid story as a preteen inspired by Natalie Portman's character in Leon, the Professional. Interestingly, Meryl's age wasn't changed because of the inappropriate age difference to Snake, it was because the weapon she used, a Desert Eagle, couldn't be managed by a 12-year-old girl. In Police Knots, Meryl has a tattoo on her left arm, which appears to be a blue-colored version of the original FOXHOUND logo from Metal Gear 2. In Metal Gear Solid, the same tattoo can be seen on her left arm. The connection is more obvious in the GameCube version of the game, thanks to its higher graphical fidelity. Don't forget to subscribe to Did You Know Gaming for more facts and trivia. If you like this video, give it a like. And if you're a fan of Metal Gear, click the annotation on the screen to watch Did You Know Gaming's Easter Egg series on Metal Gear Solid. Also, if you're a fan, you'll want to check out my own videos at Super Bunnyhop for a healthy little collection of Metal Gear analysis, reviews, coverage, and editorials as well. I've done these super long 40-minute in-depth reviews for most of the games in the series, and also broke the story on Konami not wanting to make big video games anymore. People tell me they're good videos, so maybe they're right, but I don't know. Maybe.